Recording. Okay, there it goes. Hi. You may have decided to write because you have all of these story ideas in your head, and you're like, story ideas? Why do I need more of those bouncing around my head? I have plenty. Tell me something useful. First of all, don't talk to me like that. Second, this is for all of you out there that are having trouble coming up with ideas for your story. The rest of you can leave right now. Just kidding. Don't leave. Please. So whether you have a ton of story ideas in your head right now or you have zero, here are four ways to come up with story ideas when you're feeling stuck or when all those ideas run out, because they just might. The first thing you can do is write down your dreams. As soon as you wake up in the morning, any dreams you may have had, keep a notebook by your bed and just write them down before you forget them. This may sound like it's a little bit crazy, but I know from experience that this one can actually work. One time I had this dream where there was these two kids, a brother and a sister, on a beach, and there was some evil lady. I don't know if she was a queen or, you know, like an evil queen or witch or what she was, but there was some evil lady chasing these two kids. When I woke up, it seemed like, hey, there could be a story here. So I wrote it down. And as I started writing, it kind of became this whole story where there was two twins, a boy and a girl, who were on vacation at the beach, and they were out in a storm, and they stumbled across this portal that was only like activated by lightning. And so when the storm came and the lightning happened, and I happened to be out on the beach and right next to this portal, and just happened to be in the wrong place at the wrong time, and it activated this portal, and they went through it and they went to this other world, and that's where this evil lady was there. And I kind of stopped at that point and didn't keep going, because at that point I think I was only 15 or so, and I really wasn't taking writing that seriously, and I didn't know how to create a story yet, especially a larger one, which just probably would have became. But it could have been a pretty great story if I would have actually finished it. Hey, I always have a story idea for later. Write down your dreams. If you want to wait until it's a dream that really sparks your interest or sparks your imagination, then do that. You don't have to write down every single dream you have, especially if it's like a dream where you're eating a cheeseburger in your pajamas in front of a crowd. I don't know, something weird like that. You know, you don't have to write that down unless you want to. I mean, hey, it's your story. The second way you can find story ideas is from other stories. No, it's not cheating, as long as you don't use their story exactly. When I was a kid, this is where all of my story ideas came from. Like, I really don't remember not having some kind of story going on in my head. But usually it came from another story that I had just read or watched. Like when I was a kid, I used to watch Jungle Book all the time. And I remember having like an alternate version of that like playing in my head like a lot. In fact, the first story that I ever started writing at about, I think I was 11 or 12, was actually just an alternate version of one of the American Girl series. So never stop reading. And draw some inspiration from your favorite stories. Maybe make a list of some of the stories that you loved most and see what they have in common. Do they all have really witty, snarky characters? Or are they really warm and funny romances? Or maybe they're all fantasies that start out in our world, but then the characters go into some kind of portal and end up in a whole different world. Just take some time to see which stories it is that really speak to you, and chances are, these are the kind of stories you'll want to write. The next time that you read a book or watch a movie, just spend some time playing around with the story. Ask yourself, what if the protagonist was a male instead of female? Or what if they were a couple years older or younger? Or what if their personality was completely opposite? Like, how would that change the story? Spend some time playing around with some of your favorite stories and see what happens. The third way to get story ideas is to just start writing. Sit down at your laptop, maybe turn on a timer for about 15, 30 minutes, and just write the first thing that comes into your head. Don't question it. Don't worry about it making sense. Just start writing. I did this with one of my very first short stories called Rescued. I'll put a link to that below if you want to read it. But I did this, I just sat down and started writing. Okay, I did actually have a little bit of an idea before I started, but we won't talk about that. So yeah, I had this vague idea of a girl with a gun pressed up against her head about to commit suicide, and had no idea, what was going to happen, or who this girl was, or why she was about to commit suicide, how it would end, like anything like that. But I just sat down, I started writing, thinking the story would be finished in about 500, maybe 1,000 words, and I think it ended up being like, I don't know, 800, 900. But the point is, sometimes you just need to start writing, even if there really isn't a very clear idea, or even if you don't have any ideas. And the fourth way to find ideas is to ask yourself questions. The author of Divergent asked herself, "What would be my idea of an absolutely perfect society?" And then she realized her idea of a perfect society wouldn't actually be that great. And like the whole idea of all these people being separated into these categories of being brave or honest or selfless kind of came about. So sit down with a piece of notebook paper and write down a couple of questions and answers. You can ask yourself, what do you think would be the perfect society, and then flip it around and turn it into kind of a dystopian. You can ask yourself, what would be the most exciting place in the world for me to visit? And then maybe you could have a story take place there. Ask yourself, what would happen if everybody had a superpower and it wasn't just superheroes? And what if there were actually only a couple of people on Earth that didn't have superpowers? Maybe the government would consider their life like meaningless. Would they kill them all off? Would there be like this hunt for people that didn't have a superpower? And maybe you could make your protagonist someone who doesn't have a superpower, and they spend their whole entire life like on the run from these people who are trying to kill them. Maybe they're trying to convince people that they actually do have a superpower. That would be an interesting story. Someone should write that. You could ask yourself, what if people could breathe underwater? Or what if everyone could fly? The list is endless. Just start asking yourself crazy questions about what would happen if the world wasn't the way we knew it. And number five, I know I said I was only going to have four, but I just thought of this one. So, yeah. So we'll add that as a bonus. So, anyway, number five is to just be open to ideas everywhere. You never know when you're going to get an idea. You may come up with an idea while looking at a painting in an art museum. You may come up with one while you're taking a walk, while you're sitting at a lake, while you're even just driving or doing dishes or cleaning the house or something. You never know when an idea may just kind of pop in your head. And if you get used to acknowledging these ideas and keeping them in your head and kind of playing around with them, or maybe even writing them down, then you'll have a lot more ideas to choose from when you're thinking about finding something to write a novel or a short story with. Some authors will say to write down every single idea that comes to you. Others say this is a good way to collect bad ideas. I don't write down every single idea that comes to me because I would have way too many random ideas to file through every time I wanted to create a story. Usually, I wait and see if the idea really just stays in my head. And a lot of times, like if it's an idea that just keeps coming back to me and I keep building on it, then eventually I'll write it down. I had this happen to a story that I'm working on right now, for like a good, I don't know, 2 or 3 years. It would every now and then just kind of come in my head, and every time be a little bit different than the time before. So I had like a bunch of versions of this story in my head. And then finally, one day, I got sick over the weekend and had nothing better to do, and so I just started writing this down, and within 3 days I had about 26,000 words. I've never written that fast in my life. I was super excited because I did all of this writing in such a short amount of time. But I think if I had tried writing that story down a year before, it just wouldn't have come as easily. It just wasn't ready yet. So you may not want to write down every single idea that comes to you. Just kind of play around with it. Everyone's different. And number six, yes, another bonus, is to use Pinterest. I've talked about Pinterest before. It's a great place to get story prompts and come up with ideas. So if none of these are working for you and you're just really stumped, you can go to Pinterest, type in writing prompts, and it will pull up tons and tons of different ideas. And you just take one and start writing and see where it goes. So, what are you still doing here? Go come up with some ideas now. So, what are you waiting for? Go write. Take all these ideas and go write. So, go get some ideas now. Come up with some ideas. Get your ideas. Why is ending this always so hard? Yeah, I should stick to writing, not making videos. So, what are you guys waiting for? What are you guys waiting for? What are you guys waiting for? Go out there and come up with some ideas. That sounds really bossy. I don't want to be bossy. What else should I say? And then make sure to acknowledge me in the wonderful book that you come up with because I helped you come up with ideas.